pancreas, as you know, after the spleen, then so pancreas will be having what? How many parts? Heads of pancreas, neck of pancreas, and body of pancreas. And small part which is ending over here, this is what we call it tail of pancreas. So head of pancreas is located where? Here you can see, yes, it is L2. Okay, so this is level 1. L1 and L2 below this. So this is L2. It is covered by duodenum. Yes, now you can see a part of head which is giving a small, now you can see this is superior mesenteric artery, superior mesenteric vein. Behind this there will be small parts stuck over here like this. Now this is artery, it will be stuck over here. That is called what? Uncinate process. Processus, uncinatus. Okay? Uncinate process is the part which is going behind this. Understood? There is a gap behind this, it will go a small part. Okay? That will be called uncinate process. Next part will be what? Neck. Neck. Yes? So it will be overlying what? Superior mesenteric vessel, usually this line, this will be what? Through this body and neck will be running through L1, transpyroid line. Yes? What is important over here? The origin of portal vein will be what? Behind neck of pancreas. Next will be body. So this much will be body. It will be ascending what from here and it will be going into what? Towards spleen. And the last small part of pancreas, we call it tail of pancreas, is connected inside hilum of spleen. It will be triangular shape. Here, gastroc will come and connect posterior side. Left kidney, here it will be what? Intestine, in between what you get this porch, we call it hilum of spleen, where you will be having this part. So you should keep it in mind, if you take a cut section over here at the body, it is triangular shape. Okay? It is triangular shape. It will be having anterior surface, yes? Inferior surface and posterior surface. Okay? This is covered by peritoneum. Anterior border may you will find transverse mesocolon. The origin of transverse mesocolon will lie in this line. Understood? If you take a cut section, now from this is you will be getting parietal peritoneum and posterior part is not covered. This is called what? Extra peritoneal organ. Secondary extra peritoneal organ because it was produced in peritoneum in embryology, then it will be pushed outside. So we call it what? Secondary extraperitoneum. Primary extraperitoneum, for example, kidney was produced outside and it is sitting outside. Understood? So this is secondary extraperitoneum organ. So you should keep what this gland is actually a mixed gland. We have seen yesterday it's exocrine and endocrine. So this much part will be maximum exocrine and the tail is maximum endocrine. There where we will find what? Islet of Langerhans. You should remember alpha, zeta, gamma, delta, and epsilon. Not now for physiology. Okay? So keep it in mind again that this short portion is stuck over here and blood supply of body and tail of pancreas is given by splenic artery only. So splenic artery runs what? Superior posterior region it will be running over here and what it will be giving. And you should know that what? Here we are having gastro and this is splenic artery which is coming over here which is going to give blood also to gastro. So keep it in mind what? We call it what? Left gastroepiploic artery. Small gastric artery or we call it what? Arteriae gastrici brevis. There will be 4 to 5 small gastric arteries. They all arise from splenic artery. This part of head and uncinate process will be taking blood from what? Superior and inferior pancreatic or duodenal artery. Superior pancreatic or duodenal artery comes from what? Gastroduodenal artery, which is a branch of hepatic artery. Below from here it will come from superior mesenteric artery. So this is having a different supply, this is having a different supply. Okay. And once you are doing, for any reason, if you have disease of spleen, you want to remove spleen, yes? We call it splenectomy. You should be very careful, but in spleen, what is there? Tail. If you remove this, what will happen? You get what? Secondary diabetes. Because you cut the tail, there is no insulin. Yes? So head of pancreas, which I already told you what. So it is like it is lodged in C-shape. Yes, that is curvature of duodenum. Yes. So you will be seeing anterior will be what which I already told you. Here attaching what transverse mesocolon. So here also it will come to what. This is what hepatic flexure. From here it will be connecting over here. So from hepatic flexure it will be connecting with the posterior wall, going obliquely towards splenic flexure. Understood? So splenic flexure it will be connected to what through this below. What? So you can see over here like this. Below spleen it will be connected to the diaphragm to what ligament? What ligament? Phrenicocolic ligament. So it will hold it up. Keep it in mind. This is low and this is up. So it should be held up. Understood? So transverse mesocolon. What will be posterior? We have already seen this posterior to the head will be what inferior vena cava. And behind that, what is there? You can see this is kidney. So renal blood vessel should be there. And of course, there will be what? In the if you tell about head, yes. Posterior and in the head, there will be what? Common bile duct. Understood? Neck of pancreas, I already told you, posteriorly beginning of what? Portal vein. This is the very important point to find the origin of portal vein. Anterior, I already told you, pylori. So it will be anterior pylori. But not connecting together. Why? There will be a gap in between. We are just seeing anterior. There will be what? Omental bursa, then it will be pylori. Yes? Body of pancreas, now you can see. So, body of pancreas, yes? Anteriorly, which I told you what? Stomach will be there. We call it what? Bed of stomach, but it will be separated by omental bursa. Then you can see posterior, there are a lot of things you can understand. Yes? Abdominal iodine will be there. Then to the left, it will be left suprarenal gland. Just behind it will be the left kidney, left renal vessels, and splenic vein will be there. Only superior it will be splenic. Posterior superior is, I already told you what, splenic artery. Below that, splenic vein. So it will come behind. So superior it is celiac trunk. You can see celiac trunk is coming from here. So celiac trunk will be up. Celiac plexus will be covering this. From celiac trunk there will be three arteries coming. What they are? Common hepatic artery, splenic artery and left gastric artery. They form tripod. We call this tripod Heller's tripod. H-E-L-L-E-R. Heller's tripod. It is formed by what? Three arteries. Yes? So it runs into splenorenal ligament. I'll show you what is splenorenal ligament. So what is important thing over here, if for any disease if we are going to remove spleen, we call it splenectomy, you should be taking care for saving the tail. Otherwise, you will be getting secondary diabetes. Okay, pancreas. What is the meaning? Pan means everything. Pura. Okay, in the pura. Everything is pan. Yes? Creos. Oh, you should take it. Creas. Yes? Muscle. Hippocrates first found out when he was doing dissection this thing. So he thought, that's why he was the one who gave the first word. For gastric, there is a bed. Yes? We have studied what is gastric? Gastric bed or bed of stomach. What? Pancreas also forming bed of stomach. So he thought this is a muscular structure which is giving what? Support for stomach. So he kept a name, but this is not a gland. In that time, they don't know what is gland. So here it is full of muscle. So it became pancreas. Now still they didn't change. The real meaning is pancreas means full of muscle. Creas is muscle. Pan is full, pura. Yes? But they didn't change the name still. So it is still what? Full of muscle. So still they are using the name which was kept by Hippocrates because he is father of medicine. Yes? So they didn't change. So it is pancreas. Clear?